Kratz-Miller, and this is Liz Herman. And we both own our own independent businesses, Elizabeth Designs and Broad Spectrum. And a few years ago, we worked together on a project and noticed each other's really individual takes on the same thing and decided to get together and teach that. So we basically take one design and do our interpretation of it. And that's what you get in the class. So you get a notebook that has 20 recipes in it. We do 10 in the class, one version, but you get the recipe for the other. So basically, you'll get, for those of you who want to go out with exact recipes, you will have them. You'll have an alternate that you can do on your own. And hopefully, too, that you'll come out with some inspiration to make it your own and go on and create more recipes. There's a lot of different products that we go over, and so hopefully you'll be trained to know how to use these products and make substitutions to get your own personal looks on them. We do work in the field. We have combined probably over 30 years experience. So these recipes have all been tested on walls. They've actually been done in rooms. And so they're not. No, yeah, we don't work with samplers. Anyway, we're going to, so you're going to get two demos today. We're going to take one of the recipes from the class, and we'll see both recipes from the same sample. Liz is doing sizzling sizzle. That's the finished sample. And mine is tap the darling. Oh, and this is Scal. He's also in the class too as an assistant. So he helps wash stencils and brushes so that the project, and gets mixed and stuff so that the class is fast paced and you can actually stay focused on what you're learning, not spending time lining up the sink and then talking about boyfriends and other stuff. The inspiration for this was textiles and fashion. So it's a matter of looking, to other things besides quote finishes as inspiration, but looking out to see what other things are catching on.
So I'm checking out what you're wearing, that's why. It's a nice texture.
That's not a mortgage.
Okay. So the first step is I'm going to roll on. We're going to roll on Venetian gem finish coat. This is terracotta. Oh, first of all, the base coat is $40. It's Profex, and we put on two coats.
And then while Karen's doing that, I'm going to roll on a different product. These are the metal glow products. I don't know if any of you are familiar with these or not, but they're all metallic. There is a huge line of colors. I just ordered the binder that you can order, and there's all the real samples in it. I think it might have 1,500 colors in it, so give or take a few. But these are the metallics, they're meant to be, or we're going to roll them on. We're going to roll it on one coat over a camel set coat. Truthfully, you could use any dark color if you're trying to get rid of some stuff on your shelf. Black would probably work because of the end, you're not going to see this. But you definitely want to use the darker color so that the metallic shines. You're also going to get black lines. And because this is the vertical finish, I try to keep it vertical. Don't worry about the black lines. It's going to dump, you're not going to see it. It's just to get the color and the metallic in the background of the plaster.
To scratch coat.
Okay. I really think these things are designed to spray. I really think they're smooth, even finish. I've never had luck, and somebody else out there has, but I've never had luck even layering them, getting them without the black lines. I think if you spray them, wipe them, and spray them, it's smooth.
Karen, what's that you roll on the
terracotta?
What about that? Venetian gem terracotta. I'm using that. This is also acting as a scratch coat to the next step that's going on. Which is luster stone, and I like using a Venetian gem because it covers really easily. You can see how well it covered a lighter color in one coat. It'll also help fill in flaws, minor flaws in the wall. It sands really easily, and it's cheaper than luster stone, I think, than for using as a scratch coat. Now, if you have, you can use luster stone as a scratch coat, but I like using this.
I don't know if I mentioned this is called Santa Maria, is the name of the color. Also, this product, if you've not used it before, even though it's in this little container, this stuff goes and goes and goes. I mean, you get a lot of mileage out of these. I don't know what it says on here. Yeah. But you do get a lot of coverage out of these. Oftentimes, almost always, I do use these little whiz rollers to roll out my walls. I feel like they're a little bit thicker, and I like that orange peel look. If you're more comfortable with the big roller, go ahead and use the big roller.
They also don't come with pocket pliers much either.
So again, I'm okay with that camel popping through. Well, you know, it should be a quick step. You don't spend too much time trying to even that out, because you can see there's a lot of texture on there, so you're not going to see the roller.
Or some water, then it will.